Yo, I swear to y'all, I was giving DD 80%, man. I promise you, that's my dog. It's my dog. I love my wife. But I was giving her 80%. And I couldn't figure out for the world. I mean, I wasn't talking to nobody else. I just still couldn't give her all of me. And I didn't know what. I was like, what in the world? I'm praying every morning. I'm like, God, what's up? Like, I love this chick. I ain't trying to be with nobody else, but I just can't seem to. And I went to Miami, was doing a revival. And my boys had these chicks in the room, and they know that's like off limits. I'm like, bro, I walk in the room, these girls in the room, I'm like, bro, what's up? Homegirl sitting there, she like, sit down. I'm like, what? I don't even know you like that. She's like, sit down, the Lord told me to come here. I was like, the Lord told you? Why you ain't tell me? I'm like, I ain't trying to be funny, but this is my hotel room. You know what I'm saying? Like, we talking every day. She started with me. That's how I knew the Lord had spoken to her. Because normally we're in the room, you're going to start with my boys because they not as strong as me spiritually. She started with me. She said, you are powerful and God told me you're going to do great things. But it's something holding you back. I'm like, holding me back, bro. I ain't doing nothing wrong. I ain't even on no cocky stuff. I'm just like flat out. Everything I'm doing wrong, I know it. I'm confessing, I'm getting it right. She said, no, you got one thing that you have not given to God. I'm like, what? She's like, you've never confronted your mother about lying to you about your father. I went for a walk and was like, God, don't do me like that. Don't you do me like that. I'll do whatever you want me to do, but don't you make me go confront my mother. She went through hell, God, and you know that. Whatever she's dealing with, you talk to her about it. Don't send me. He said, you need to go talk to your mother. Because that love, that 20% you want to give your wife, you'll never be able to give that to her because you don't trust your mother. And if you don't trust your mother, you will never trust another woman. You need to go fix it with your mother, son. That was the hardest conversation I've ever had in my life. But I said to my mom, why'd you lie to me? I went to my father because we ain't got no relationship. What? Why you lie? I went to my man's face. Like, what? I said, God, I can't talk to her face to face. I call her on the phone. And when I went in the mainframe and I fixed that, I was able to give Didi 120% of my love. Some of you, for real, that's what I'm trying to tell you. You got stuff you ain't fixing. You playing. You're trying to move forward when you ain't fixed the mainframe. And until you fix the mainframe, ain't nothing else going to work. Take ownership. Take the parts that belong to you. My father not gonna come to me. I gotta go to him. Why? Because something in my brain is saying, I need to find out why he wasn't in my life. So don't put it on him to come to you. He might not even need to talk to you. My man might not be at the crib like, my son's out there somewhere. And I don't have a relationship with him and I can't sleep. My man might be chilling. I'm the one that's hurting. I'm the one that's messing up opportunities. I'm the one that keeps repeating my past, the mainframe. You are eating what you eat. You are making decisions that you're making because you made them 10 years ago. And you need to free yourself up and start doing something new. But you can't do new until you get rid of that old.